Okay, so you didn't like the prequels.
Here's Johnny.
So much has been said about the Star Wars prequels that I risk just yelling into the void with this essay. But I hope to take a new angle and open up a productive discussion on the legacy of George Lucas's second trilogy, rather than engage more in the reductive analysis of, quote, what went wrong. Because, honestly, a lot went right. The genesis of this essay is a fantastic piece by a critic for The New Yorker, Richard Brody. He's a critic I respect greatly, but one I don't always agree with. Even when I disagree with him, though, his criticism is well-reasoned and interesting. Perhaps the grand Mac Daddy of all his critical claims is the article I alluded to. In it, Brody makes the case that the best of the Star Wars films are Attack of the Clones and, especially, Revenge of the Sith. Wow. Hot take. I encourage everyone watching to take 10 minutes to read the article because Brody approaches the Star Wars series fresh, not having followed along over the years. And the insights he uncovers are not about what the films mean in the context of Star Wars fandom, but what they mean as films, as works of art. That's how I want to dissect Attack of the Clones here, but I want to go a step further and also discuss what Attack of the Clones and the prequels in general contribute to the Star Wars universe, something that Brody doesn't address because he's not really a Star Wars fan. Let's jump into it.
If you'll excuse me.
I hate it when he does that.
I'm going to break down Attack of the Clones in terms of sound, image, and story, recognizing that these blend together and analyzing where Lucas succeeds as a skilled director and an imaginative storyteller. Sound has long been Lucas's strong point, and he brings his A game to Attack of the Clones. The sound design and mix are memorable pretty much from start to finish. My favorite moment of non-soundtrack sound in the film is the seismic detonators used by Jango Fett against Obi-Wan.
Stand by.
The sound they make has stuck with me since childhood. It's one of those inventive sound effects like the hum of a lightsaber or the shot of a blaster that Lucas is so adept at. And by the way, that lightsaber hum sounds absolutely delicious in Attack of the Clones. What stands out most to me in the category of sound, though, is the magnificent score by John Williams. I honestly think he did some of the finest work of his career in Attack of the Clones. Anakin and Padme's theme, Across the Stars, is maybe my favorite musical piece from all of Star Wars, and serves as a rich emotional backdrop for the tragic core of the Star Wars saga, Anakin and Padme's ill-fated relationship. Williams plays with this theme and my other favorite, the Jedi theme, in a wonderful moment on Tatooine. During the funeral for Anakin's mother, when Anakin is promising to become powerful enough to stop death, a strange distortion and fusion of Across the Stars and the Jedi theme plays. This brilliantly foreshadows the way Anakin will try to manipulate the Force to save Padme, the crutch of his fall to the dark side. Both themes are distorted, showing that this decision will not bode well for either the balance of the Force or Anakin and Padme's relationship. Very cool. Okay, now for image. This is often where a director shows the most mastery, where they tell the story with the camera. Yes, George Lucas is not a very inventive director of dialogue. But he is an exceptional visual director, and he comes to life during the action sequences of Attack of the Clones.
Uh-huh.
that just looks awesome. Generally speaking, the look of Attack of the Clones is distinct from both Episode 1 and the original trilogy, and the palette is rich and striking. My favorite sequence in the film is the opening action scene on Coruscant, where Obi-Wan and Anakin chase the bounty hunter who attempted to assassinate Padme. This is a true blue, bona fide Star Wars action scene, right at home with the best of the rest of the series. Lucas puts us convincingly into the skies of the megacity of Coruscant as Obi-Wan clings to the assassin droid. Lucas smartly had Coruscant evolve, or really devolve since Episode 1, from a shiny city to a slightly dystopian sprawl reminiscent of Blade Runner. And here's a nice little nod to that film. But it's not a carbon copy, and this feels like a uniquely Star Wars place, and shows the way that the dark side is starting to seize control and corrupt the universe. My favorite moment of visual storytelling is one simple little shot back on Tatooine. When Anakin is leaving to go find his mother, Lucas chooses to shoot their shadows against the Lars home, a rare moment where Lucas has a brilliant idea in a dialogue scene. This spices things up a little visually, but more than that, I love how this tells the story of the shadow that Anakin and Padme's relationship will cast on the Star Wars universe, and literally here, the Lars home. Remember, events set in place by Anakin and Padme's children, Luke and Leia, literally destroy the home and its occupants. And all they wanted was to farm moisture. The story of Attack of the Clones is my last point, and bleeds into my conclusion. You have to hand it to Lucas for inventing an entire universe of politics and philosophy, even if most fans weren't all that interested in it. His choice made Star Wars more of a Shakespearean epic, and, a love or hate the midichlorians, the lore of the prequels injected a rich spiritualism and history into Star Wars that just wasn't there before they came along. I'd also argue that so much of what Star Wars fans love about the Star Wars universe and think about as being authentically Star Wars is dependent on the prequels. For example, when you think about a lightsaber duel, chances are you think of a fast-paced, acrobatic one from the prequels, not the slower, somewhat arthritic ones of the original trilogy. Lucas set out to do something totally unique with the prequels, and I think he accomplished that. They're each distinct films that fit into the Star Wars universe, but don't just sing along to it. They add depth and color and emotion that has been an influence on a generation of Star Wars fans who grew up with them, me included. Thanks for watching.